Hello. Very good morning to all. BISP welcomes all of you in today's SAS Best and Advanced demo class. And today's demo classes will be taken by Mr. Siddharth. He is having around 5 years of experience in his domain, and he is very good hands-on and very good knowledge about this. So he is going to take today's demo class. For better audio quality, people will be on mute. And if you have any questions in between, you can put the same in GoToMeeting chat window. At the end of class, we will unmute people so you can speak with Siddharth for any technical queries and doubts. Thank you. So I'm giving this class to Siddharth, and we are starting now. Thank you.
Come to here, like I would like to start with history of SAS. It was developed in early 1960s at North Carolina State University, so by a graduate student by the name is Anthony Jabor. So being a graduate student by the point of time, he wanted to do some kind of statistical analysis with his academic research. He is developed this software by this time. And later this board has collaborated with Jim Goodnight, and later they have integrated a few more features, like a kind of, you know, regression and analysis of areas to this software which was developed by Jabor. And then later it got full-fledged, you know, efficiency. Once it got all kind of efficiency, then, you know, initial point of time, the people, they start utilizing these kind of, you know, pretty much software just for their management and as well as statistical analysis of agriculture field experiments. And by that time, the people initially, they used to call this a kind of statistical analysis tool. And later point of time, the moment when the beauty was going to be utilized by many of the industries, it won't only for agriculture, you know. Now the software is going to be used across all sectors, predominantly like a farmer, healthcare, or banking, financial, marketing, or retail. And there are many number of industries now they are going to use. So being in earlier, SAS is going to be used an acronym like a statistical analysis software or a system. But after it's diversifying into other areas, now it's no more an acronym. So we used to pronounce SAS. Now the SAS is taken care by SAS Institute from North Carolina State University, United States of America. So to be going further, like coming to the overview, if you see SAS, there are many of the activities that a user can be fed from, but broadly it was categorized into these really areas. So that is the reason majority of the people, they might use SAS as an integrated system for many of the software solutions. Over here, primarily we can go through a data entry kind of activities which we can fed from with help of SAS, and even we can retrieve the data and as well as we can do the management of the data. And in a similar fashion, if we want, because if I have a data, if I want to kind of generate kind of a reports, for that time also I can go and I can use the software where I can generate the reports and as well as I can design even the graphical things also. And some people, they might use SAS just for their decision making things. For example, what could be, you know, future business it is, and because they can get always kind, they have a data in their hand, just they want to understand what data it is, how exactly the data. So for that reason, you know, they can use SAS software for their business planning, and as well as they can easily understand what is going to happen in coming future. So likewise, they can easily forecast and they can easily make a decision. And as well as if I have a huge amount of data, but I need to understand what data it is under. So for that, even we can do, you know, kind of statistical analysis and as well as a mathematical analysis can be also done by SAS. And to be more extended, some people, they might use SAS just for quality and as well as operational research and also a project management kind of activities can also be performed with a SaaS software. And very few people they can use SaaS for application development activities. So these are really major kind of activities that majority of the people they can perform with the SaaS. But to be major extent, the SaaS can be utilized majority of data-driven tasks. If you see a data-driven task, because in a daily days we used to we are accommodated with huge amount of data. By seeing a data, we cannot understand what it is. So altogether, with help of a SaaS, what exactly we can do, using data, we are making the entire whatever the data which we used to see, right? We are making them in more in meaningful way. So to be that, if you see in SaaS, we are performing major four tasks. The very first one we used to perform your data access, because as I told, we used to come across huge amount of data between a number of sources. If I want to understand what data it is, first I need very well, I have to access the data. So for that reason, the foremost step in measurement of the data-driven task, I can call it data access. So the moment once I access the data, then my job is moving to a management. So if I want to make any kind of, any kind of analysis, I need to maintain my data in a standard organized way. So there's a reason I'm using data management activity. The moment once a data is managed in a unique way, then I can send all my data for my analytical purpose. So the moment once I done my analytical purpose, then I can go on very well to present and to represent in more understandable manner. So that's why these are the majority of the data-driven tasks that we can perform majorly in a SaaS. If you can see in a SaaS, how we exactly we are converting, because as I told, we used to come across huge amount of data, but if you can see among them, 80% of our related works, it was related to only a data-related activity, such kind, access kind of a data and scrubbing and as well as transformation and manage and as well as store and retrieval. But among them, only 20% it was an end where we used to perform kind of analytical activities. So in this way, we can easily convert, data into more in informative way. So using SaaS, how exactly we can do here? I try to show, in a pictorial way. You see, irrespective, because here also I have shown in a more in pictorial. If you can see here, initially I have a data. Might be this data here at the moment. I'm trying to say you it's a data. Might be data might be residing in a number of sources. So we are least bother what source it is, but wherever the source is, with help of a data access facility, we will access and we will get the data. For that, initially how exactly we are turning data into more information way, in a sense, this is our source data was residing over here. So once a data was available, what exactly we can do, right? With help of a SaaS, in SaaS programming, there are two basic entities. One entity I can call as a data step and another entity I can call them as a prod. So what exactly we can do, right? With help of a data step, we will fetch the data into the SaaS and finally we are going to create a SaaS data sets. So the moment once I created a SaaS data set and then later point of time, whatever kind of procedure that I want to perform. If I want to do kind of statistical, I can perform a statistical. If I want to perform a kind of graphical, I can perform a kind of graphical operations. If I want to perform any kind of other transformation, I can perform use the procedures. So that is a way, whatever kind of data, with help of a data set, we are going to create in a SaaS data sets. And then with help of a proc steps, we are performing our desired operations. And then finally, we are converting the entire data into more meaningful information way. So this is a way, like in a SaaS, we are always, we are going to always going to creating a data steps and as well as a proc steps. Coming to the design of SaaS system, it's a multi-vendor in technology. It means like even you can install your software on normal PC or a workstation, even a server, even a mainframe, because so some people they might ask like, so what is the difference between mainframe and what is the difference between Unix version and what is the difference between a PC? It means like, you know, I can tell you, you know, 90% it was an independent the hands-on, and whereas coming to 10%, you know, so you have to change, you know, little syntactical. The rest of the part is, you know, it was much simpler. So that's what we can call the SaaS can be utilized, you know, multi-vendor in technology. Any people they can use, and based upon the domain people they might use, which version they have to choose it. So if you see a banking kind of people, majority of the people, they can use Unix version. If you say like a pharma industry, they can use Windows version. And there are some kind of people, you know, like they might pretty well utilize, you know, mainframe version of software that they can utilize. So that's the reason why it can be, you know, complex with any kind of operating system. Even we can work as a software even our Macintosh also. So coming to accessibility, so in simply here I can call this is a multi-engine architecture. It means like as I told you, whatever the source, because my data was residing either in a Teradata, either my data is residing in Sybase, or either my data is acclimatized either, you know, normal Microsoft source like Excel, you know, so we can get access. If my data is available in Oracle, even we can access like even the DBase and even the SAP. So it means like, you know, whatever the source of system, with help of SaaS, we can easily fetch the data. Such kind of, you know, compliant SaaS can extend it. So that is the reason why majority of the time, whenever the people want to do kind of any analyticals at the top end, as a primary input, they might use SAS, you know, for these things. And coming to more of a programmatical part, as I told, being a SaaS program, we are always performing, you know, two kind of activities. The one which I told you, data step, and the second one is a proc step. So for example, if you can see here also, I'm trying to show you a raw data. Might be my raw data might be reside, you know, either a flat file, either my data file is available in a table, in a Oracle or a Teradata, either this way or else, whatever the data which we are doing, you know, with help of a data step, we are creating SAS data sets. The moment once I created a SAS data set, then I can use it kind of a proc step. Then I'm going to generate a kind of report. So that is the reason why always data step, I can always term them. You know, this is a typical procedure where we can fetch the data from an external environment into SaaS environment. The moment when a data can be available in a SaaS environment, then whatever my desired, you know, procedures, if I want to generate a kind of graph, I can generate. If I want to edit kind of data, I can edit. If I want to kind of, you know, sort the data, I can do. And if I want to kind of any statistical, I can perform with help of a proc steps. To be more, you know, here I would like to show you a software. This is the SAS software, which is always, you know, rectangular, inverted triangle in shape. So if you can see in this software, the moment once you open software, we are broadly going to see there are five windows. The very first window, we can call them as editorial window, where whatever kind of program which you want to write and which you want to execute and which you want to be, you know, edit. So those kind of majority of kind of operations which we can perform in this environment. moment once you open this software, we are broadly seeing, five windows. The very first window, I can term them as an editorial window or else enhancer window. Some of the versions where we can call them this version, enhancer window. So if you can see in the editorial window, we're working that stuff, like majority of the programming stuff, we can perform in this window. So the moment once we execute all our program and the moment, so if my program having any kind of information, either kind of, notes, warnings or error, everything where I can track in another window called log window. These are place, if suppose I have executed a piece of code and I made some mistake, might be it's a kind of an error, I can tell. So all kind of errors I can easily track in my log window. So that is advantage of it. I'm trying to give the basic programming part, how exactly we are going to write a basic SAS programming. As I discussed you, the basic SAS programming typically having two steps. One is a data step and one is a prop step. So here I'm trying to show you how exactly we are going to creating a data step. So the moment once we have created a data step, how exactly we can, creating a SAS data set. So since we have a raw data, so to access the data, with help of a data step, we are going to creating a SAS data set. The moment once a SAS data set is created, with help of a prop procedure, we can perform our desired operation, and finally we are going to generating our desired report. So now I'm going to show you how exactly we are going to creating a SAS data set in our SAS environment. As I told you, whatever the kind of programming which we are going to write, we are always used in our editorial window. For that, here I am going to creating a normal data step. So if I want to create any, I request you all, are you able to access my desktop? Like Satish, Asha. Can you give me a quick okay if you are able to see my desktop, because whatever I'm... is working in.
Okay.
So if you see here, right? Because for example, as I told you, till now, I have shown you SAS programming, but where exactly we have to use SAS programming part? This is a typical SAS software which was installed in our Windows environment. If you can see a Windows environment, broadly there are three windows which we are always using. If you can see editor window, this is a place where exactly all our piece of code which
okay.
we want to. So that is the reason why, as I told you, broadly SAS program we have categorized into two steps. One is a data step and
Right.
another one is a proc step.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. So if I want to create a data step, I should always start with a keyword with followed by a data, and which should always follow by a name. For example, I hope you might aware of RDMS systems. If you see any RDMS
yeah.
system, we are all relational data management systems. Like if you see a Teradata, if you see a Oracle, how exactly we are loading all our data in databases, we are always loading our data in a table manner, right? We are storing the data in a tables. In a table, how exactly we are loading our tables? In rows and columns, right? In the same way, even in a SAS, the terminology for that, like in our normal,
so, we know what is data storage mechanism in here, in sir. Does it store any data, or only we are plugging it to sources?
Yeah, we are going to store entire data in a data sets.
Okay.
If you see any database, we are always storing entire data in as a table in manner. Okay. So in a DBM system, like in all databases, we are always storing our entire data in a table manner. How we exactly tools organize in a manner of rows and columns. In the same fashion, if you can see in SAS, we are storing entire all our information in a SAS data sets.
Okay.
How we exactly these data sets can be organized? You know, observations.
So these are metadata or actual data?
What are metadata? Come again?
Yeah, these are metadata or actual data, data sets.
Actual data, actual data.
Okay, okay. So where this is getting stored? In which area? RAM or what part of
yeah,
the data?
Yeah, well, that is very good. So the moment as I told you, right, if it is TBS, I told it's a table. If it is SAS, I told it's a kind of data sets. In a SAS,
right.
we have a space called libraries. The moment if you can open a libraries, where you can see broadly, you know, there are four libraries which are all SAS defined libraries, and even user can himself also can create his own defined libraries. So that is where I can call whatever kind of data which we are always accessing in a SAS environment, which will go and reside in these libraries. And
so
if you
that
can
is
see,
that
open
data resides in a file format or any other format is there?
This is SAS dataset. Format only. So if you can see, I'm just trying to open anything. So this is a look and feel of, you know, my data which was residing in my library.
Okay. Okay. Got
okay.
it.
So like this, we used to get. So broadly, right? Some point, what exactly we are always doing, you know? Sometimes we are going to creating our own data sets. If I want to create any data set, first I have to create data step. So with help of a data step, right, I can fetch the data into SAS environment. So that means, it means the moment once I created, you know, any data step, now here I'm trying to show you the basic data step, data. By class, here in this, as I told you, in this data set, I'm going to specify two of my columns. The very first my column is subject student ID, then his age. If you can see in this table, I just want to load the data call, student ID is 11, his age equal to 23, his ID equal to 12, and his age equal to 24. Is ID equal to 13, is age equal to 45. Just consider.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is typical, I can call them as a SAS data step. I will explain you in detail what is all about and why I have written each and every step. Now,
okay.
I'm always followed by creating a proc step, proc followed by a data, because since using this data step, I have created in class and then I'm going to executing run. So what exactly, typically this entire program I can call them SAS programming. If you can see, I'm executing whole piece of code. So to execute this, whatever the piece of code which I have written in my editor, I have to select and I have to execute by submitting this running icon. The moment when I submit my icon, here you are able to see in my output window the outputs. Student ID and his age, right? And as I told you, the moment once I execute any piece of code, we can track our total entire our log information in this environment, like a kind of log. So that is a way where we can track all kind of nodes. If I made any kind of mistakes like errors or warnings, everything I can track here. Okay. So as I told you, the moment once I execute any piece of code, it will go on residing in libraries. By default, it will go on reside in our work library. So that is default destination of our SAS environment. So here I have created SAS dataset by the name class. It go on resided in my work library. So if you can select and double click, right, it will show you what only data. Got it?
Yeah.
So this is a way. So this is a way which way. And if I want to kind of any kind of mean, right, statistical, here I would like to show normal mean. So there are kind of procedure called like a proc mean. For example, if it is, you know, I have a 1 to 100 records, or if it is 1 to 1000 records, I can easily handle. But if you can see in an industry where we are accessing billions of records, and we have to access, and we need to get, you know, some sort of, you know, statistical reports. So we need to understand what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value, what is the average value, all kind of operations to be more of a statistical procedures. For that, SAS inbuilt itself, there are some standard statistical procedures itself was available. So here I am trying to show you mean of this data set. It altogether showing for subject ID, the mean of all my records is this standard deviation, this is a minimum value, this is a maximum value. And if you see, yes, the mean is this and standard deviation is this, the minimum and maximum value of like this. So in less than 30 seconds, it will return our results. Likewise, you know, I can perform kind of statistics, whatever desired statistics that we can perform. Sometimes, you know, where we want to create some kind of reports also.
Yeah.
So I have data. I want to generate a data in a more of representing, in a reporting, right?
Right.
This was a typical very, very simple procedure. The moment once I execute, right, you are going to see kind of procedures.
So it's a kind of student ID you have created.
Yes. What is their contribution? Likewise, you know, we can do any kind of statistical analysis and we can do any kind of data representation. As I discussed with you in my very first program, our first and foremost step, you know, we have to initially get the data access. So some point it on my data, right, whatever my source data might having its own native. So in my management activity, I need to maintain all my data in my standardized organized way. So once my data was organized in unique way, then I can perform my own analysis. The moment once I perform my analysis, then finally I will go for representation. So likewise, these kind of all activities which we can perform. Okay. Then.
Yeah, got it.
So these are typical SAS programming. So that is what here, you know, this is data set. So from here to, as I told you, from here to here, right, we are always call them as a data step. Using data step, I'm going to creating a data set. The moment once a data set has created, then I can decide. Initial I printed. If I want to print, if I can select, it will print.
Okay.
So it means my desired operation I can perform always with my procs. Okay. So that is okay. Here I'm trying to show you. This is entire step is data and this is my proc step. And as I told you, yeah, broadly SAS always having to always starts with either with the data as a keyword or else as with a proc keyword. And it always terminated with a run statement or as a quit statement. So likewise it is going to be, you know. And if you can see data SAS data step boundaries, data is a step boundary and round proc is a step boundary and as well as a proc.
Okay, after run only it is creating data. After run only it is running the process.
Yes. Right? So till the run right, till the program is identifying or run right, it's the system always thinks that you know, the moment once it will encounter run right, it start executing.
Okay. So committing also, it is executing and committing into that system. That
yes. System. Yes. It's right? A kind of program terminator I can call them.
Okay.
So if you can see in advances where we are using SQL, so since that is an SQL, right, instead of run statement, we are using quit statement. So until or unless run statement or quit statement, it always recognize, it start understand, oh, these are all kind of SAS statements. Based upon that, it will reading and the moment once it encounter run or quit, it start executing and finally it will compile and finally it return the results in our output window.
Okay.
So that is a way, you know. Yeah. So if you see the SAS environment, this is a way look and feel. And majority of, you know, or most of training program will be in our SAS Windows environment. And if you see, as I told you, the SAS can be used even our mainframe environment. This is a look and feel of our mainframe environment. Even Windows, even Unix environment also we can be also performed. But majority of the people, right? They can use SAS in our Windows environment.
Yeah.
Okay.
We have one question on my side.
Yes. Yeah.
One question is there. SAS is quite old programming system, statistical system. Okay. Data application system. Okay. For scientists, for programming, or for data analytics and those kind of things. New analytics system is coming up. How it will fight with R software, you know?
Yes, I understand. Yes.
Yeah. So how that is going to plan according to you?
Understand. Well, that is a very good question. To answer for your question, right? I would like to tell you, you know, what totally strengthen of SAS. So that you can understand. I hope you might aware of, you know, the data warehousing, right? So if a source was residing with help of ETL, we will fetch the data. And the moment once an ETL has been, then followed by we are using, you know, kind of, then in between even our analytical, then finally we are going to, you know, kind of reporting.
Right.
So these are really major activities that any industry can be achieved. But what is the beauty and why a SAS is going to be used? If you see in major industry, for ETL, we are used to see Informatica.
Yeah, any tool, Informatica, Ab initio, or any BO.
Yes. And coming to the SAS, right, there are commutated to the SAS, that is SPSS.
Okay.
SIS. SysTat.
So SPSS is ETL tool for SAS?
No, it's a kind of analytical tool.
Okay.
Here I am trying to categorizing.
Okay.
ETL for Informatica.
Got it.
Okay. And for analytical, we are using, you know, SAS R. These are the competitive level. For reporting, we have a Cognos, right?
Yeah.
So TableView and ClickView and all these tools are available in the market.
Right.
Okay. So what exactly, you know, majority of the people till now, I can say not till now, I can say, you know, 5 years back, broadly SAS can be used only for analytical spectrum. The moment when SAS is going to evaluate it, even, you know, in a SAS, whatever the things which Informatica can be performed, we have a tool called DI Studio. So that is in a data integrated studio. Itself, right, we can perform ETL kind of activities. Our core of SAS, it was purely done for analyticals. And whereas kind of whatever the things which a Cognos can achieve, a SAS can also achieve. With kind of, you know, SAS ODS and SAS reporting facilities. So that is the reason why major kind of vendor, instead of depending upon multi-vendor to achieve a single solution, majority of the people they are using SAS. It's not only for their analytical, even they will can, you know, upstream and even downstream facilities also they can achieve it. And
I heard that licensing is very costly.
Yes, that is true. I'm accepting. But the range of, you know, kind of statistical facilities that we can achieve in SAS, we cannot see those kind of, you know, such kind of futures in other competitive tools. If you see kind of, you know, R, I accept it, it's a kind of open source. Their kind of operations, well, it was very limited. But the range of operation, everything can be
but
inbuilt,
you know,
in SAS software.
Yeah, but in this the trend which in last since last 1 and 2 years I'm able to see, I'm also a statistical guy. Okay, and
Great. What? Yes. Which software you are using for a statistical?
I'm OBI architect guy.
House. Okay. Oh, good. Okay.
Okay, that's why I'm getting all the things which you are explaining me. Okay.
I understand. Yes. Good.
Yeah. So in these times, big data and Hadoop and those kind of systems are going on. And integration of our software, I'm seeing that they are very closely integrating those things.
Yeah.
But where that, we are integrating, sir.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. I can tell you, it's smart volume might be there are even Hadoop itself, it's open source, right?
Right.
And which can very well integrate with open source called like R.
Right.
So there are some limitations which R cannot be performed. So that is a way SAS itself says MH, and even SAS itself, you know, collaborated with a Hadoop and it's giving some kind of desired statistics. If you can see Hadoop and SAS, you can see it's not only right with the SAS. As I told you in my very first slide, if you see majority of the industries, even we can perform, you know, kind of forecasting, even we can do kind of decision making where we can do business planning and operational research and stuff. So that is a way SAS is used, and it was, you know, pioneer in the market. So these kind of facilities which we cannot see in other, however, you know, if you see in R itself, the basic kind of, you know, procedure or basic kind of algorithm where we can execute. Beyond that, there is always a kind of limitation. If you can see, the kind of industries which they are using SAS, I'm trying to you know, narrate you.
Yeah.
So might be if you can take a banking industry, right? The Reserve Bank of India, they are using SAS software just for their analytical activities. And if you can see the pharmaceutical industry, coming from GSK, Pfizer, even from a Dr. Reddy, everyone, people are using, you know, this kind of software.
Actually, there were no analytical software in the market at that time. Mostly, if you if we will analyze a lot of
engineers. Irrespective of the many tools are available, they have to use only SAS.
Okay.
So that is the reason if you can see, in especially the clinical industry, the only the tool, the promised tool that is the SAS.
Right.
It's not only one and two operations, because as I told you, a vendor, he has to depend upon multiple vendors. And to perform any of the activities, he has to recruit multi-versatile technology people, multi-resources. If SAS itself, if SAS can do end-to-end solution with a similar technology people, he can be easy well. And nowadays in the market, you know, if you see banking and financial, it was more of a competitive. And it's not only analytical, the people there are always pretty looking towards a forecasting. So that is the reason why forecasting and data addition support and business planning, majority of the people and the range of, you know, statistical facilities which were available in a SaaS, right? So that is the reason why majority of the people, they are looking at the SaaS, even though a number of tools are available in the market. But if their role is very minimal, yes, I can accept. They can go with R.
And I suppose SaaS is easier to learn, right?
What? Yes.
I will compare with R, SaaS will be easier to learn because coding and those kind of things are pretty much simple.
Yes.
Okay. Because here only we are focusing data steps and that process steps.
Yes, yes. So that is the way we are, because data stuff is a way where SAS, because you know, if it is your native format, if it is Excel or if it is RDM system, might be my data is available like a columns or might be my data available like a different data set values. To understand those really data, so we are using a data step, we are creating SAS data set. The moment once my data is available in my data set, my, you know, SAS can easily understand and finally it can perform its desired activity. Okay?
Got it.
So these are the step boundaries and here I'm trying to show you. And this is a typical Windows environment looks like. These are where exactly we are going to execute. And if you see, even we can execute even a batch execution. If you see in mainframe environment, we are creating, you know, the same SAS programming part, but to be in front, we are adding some JCL, job controlling language, which we are going to add in. So that is where we are executing our piece of code even in mainframe environment. And the moment once I submit any SAS program, we always come across with the SAS logs and as well as output. If you see the SAS log, as I told you, we can able to see all notes, errors, or warnings where we can track in our log window. Whereas in output window, where we can see, you know, all kind of reports which we have executed,
right,
in our. And these are typical log, and these are typical output which we can see. These are typical, you know, main procedure that we are going to see in our output window.
Yeah.
Okay. So that is it from my end. Are there any questions, like Satish?
No, we actually got everything answered.
You're good enough, right? Even if you can see, right, might be even education industries people, right, they started utilizing this software because of, you know, the advantages of it.
Yeah.
Okay, then. Yeah, then that is here from my end.
Do you have any idea what is average licensing cost for software?